All right, in the last tutorial, I showed you how to submit your podcast to almost all of the listening apps except for Apple. Apple's submission process is more manual, but I highly recommend that you still submit to Apple. It's a very important platform, and you'll be missing out on 30 to 40% of listeners if you don't submit to their directory. So I'm going to start the process, and it's going to take me to Apple Podcast Connect. You're going to log in with your existing Apple ID. If you don't have one, you can create one here. So I'm going to do that now. And once you're finished creating your Apple ID or logging in, it should take you to this screen that says add an RSS feed with your RSS feed already filled in. Now, if it doesn't take you to this screen, what you're going to want to do is head up here to this plus sign, click on that, and then click New Show. Then it's going to ask you, do you want to add an RSS feed? Do that. If your RSS feed isn't automatically populated in there, head back to Transistor and either here in your Overview tab or in your Distribution tab, you'll find your RSS feed. Copy that to your clipboard, bring it in, and paste it in to the RSS feed URL. Then Apple will take you to this screen. And unfortunately, you're going to have to wait here for a little bit while it processes your show details. This can take a few minutes to an hour, so you'll just have to keep checking back. Once your show details appear here, you'll be able to proceed with the submission. All right, after a few minutes of refreshing, my show details have populated here in Podcast Connect. The next thing you'll need to do is review all your details, and they're going to want you to choose the frequency at which your episodes come out. So I'm going to choose weekly, and I'm also going to say this show does not contain third-party content. I'm going to head up to the top, click Save, and then I'm going to click Publish. All right, so now my show has been submitted to Apple Podcasts. And what we'll do is here in Transistor in your distribution tab, we'll keep pinging Apple Podcasts until we can see a public Apple Podcasts URL there. And then we'll update this with your Apple Podcasts URL. And just like Spotify and the other directories, you'll also receive an email notification, in this case from Apple Podcasts, when your podcast is live in Podcast Connect and the Apple Podcasts directory. You'll also be able to find that here in Apple Podcast Connect, down here, Apple Podcasts URL. If I copy that, I can paste it in, and it'll bring me to the Apple Podcast app in this case. Once it's had time to index things, it will also show you a website page for your podcast. And that is how you submit to Apple Podcasts. In the next tutorial, I'm going to show you how podcast analytics work.